final speaker today is Lee Chan. He founded China Labor Watch, a New York-based independent nonprofit organization, in 2000. He has a network of people in China who are in the plants in the electronics industry. And they send reports to him, and he gathers the information together, and he has a report that he'll be releasing soon on an inspection of 10 factories that was recently done. He's frequently cited in the international media, and he has a whole network of scholars, lawyers, and activists around the world who are working with him. He was born in China himself. He'll be speaking through an interpreter. He was a visiting scholar at the Center for the Study of Human Rights at Columbia University, and has come down from New York today for us. We're very grateful. Lee Chan.
I speak Chinese, sorry. 刚才戴丽讲的就对不正常情况做了一个比较深入的一个分析。
So just now, Daddy gave a very detailed analysis of situations at Foxconn.
这是非常深入的一个报告。It's
a very in-depth report.
这个就是非常感谢 Rose 邀请我来这里分享一下我的工作经验。
Thank you very much, Mr. Ross Eisenberg, for the opportunity to share my experience protecting workers' rights in China.
就过去十年，我一直在美国从事劳工的这个权益倡导工作。 这个苹果和这个 Fair Labor 都说这个富士康不是血缘工厂，我认为不是这样的。So
over the past 11 years, I have been in the U.S. advocating for the rights of Chinese workers. Both Apple and FLA deny that Foxconn factories are not special.
当然，就传统意义来讲，这个血缘工厂的定义是那个工人在危险的和苦难的这种情况工作，包括有害的物质。 低温、辐射为主，工时长、工资低等等。但现在社会这种情况是完全发生变化了。就是我认为的血缘那个工厂的话，就是富士康是把工人当成机器的一个部分。这个其高明的压榨具体表现在工人要满足加班才可以满足他的生活的这个需求，上班时间内的这个劳动强度非常大。只有在工作非常那个严肃冷酷的情况下，富士人的价值，就人的承受力，这样的工厂就是血缘工厂。
So the traditional definition of sweatshop is a factory where workers work in tough and dangerous environments. They may be exposed to hazardous materials, extreme temperatures, or radiation, and must work long hours for low wages. However, this definition must be modified for modern society. At Foxconn, workers are treated like machines, and they can only earn enough to live on by working excessive overtime. The labor intensity at Foxconn is extremely high, and the working environment is indifferent and harsh. The value of human life is disregarded, and workers are regularly pushed beyond their physical and emotional limits. I believe such a factory is a sweatshop.
就我们可以想一想，假如有一个在美国的有一个工厂，如果一个工人每天要站着10个工作小时远离家乡，他可能几年都不可能和家人见面。 因为没有工厂没有足够的假期，他的基本工资还不够维持他的基本生活，他必须通过加班来增加他的收入，同时加班工资常常会被克扣，有时甚至还要那个拿不到他的加班工资，他会被工厂的这个管理人员的辱骂，那个在高强度的工作之后，工人往往是不能够适合这个工作强度，还会被工厂淘汰，这样的工厂如果在美国，我想问一下算不算是血汗工厂？
So let's imagine a factory in the U.S. where a worker must work on his feet for 10 hours a day. He lives thousands of miles away from home and cannot return to see his family for years because the factory doesn't offer him enough leave time. His base salary is not enough to cover his most basic expenses, so he is forced to work overtime. However, his overtime salary is often withheld or even unpaid. He is constantly abused verbally by his managers. After several years of work, he will be forced to leave his position because he can no longer keep up with the intense pace of the job. What do you think of this factory? Is it a sweatshop or not?
在2006年的时候，当时我们那个介绍记者去对富士康做了一个报告。当时这个报告出来以后，这个苹果对富士康做了一个跟踪的调查。在2006年的时候，富士康 苹果的这个审计报告中就已经发现了这些问题，比如工人工作时间60个小时，有超过6天，然后6天之后还拿不到工资，然后呢他们这个就每星期有时候还工作7天。在这份报告里面，这个工厂的那个但是在这个富昌那个苹果自己的调查里面就只是提到了说工人的宿舍情况不好，然后要改变。
So in 2006, China Labor Watch helped a journalist organize a visit to Foxconn. After the journalist reported the working conditions at Foxconn, Apple did a follow-up investigation. This is what they said in their own audit report in 2006. We did find that employees worked longer hours than permitted by our code of conduct, which limits normal work weeks of 60 hours and require at least 1 day off each week. We reviewed 7 months of records for multiple shifts of different production lines and found that working limits were exceeded 35% of the time. But in this report, the only problem that Apple mentioned was the living conditions at the dormitories.
这个刚才的其实在富士康的网站上面的这些资料，它的检查2006年的一个审计结果。
So all this was quoted from Apple's own audit report in 2006, which is available on their own website.
当时我们在那个调查时，我们拍了一张相片，这个相片里面大概有300个工人住在一个宿舍。那个在这个事实面前，苹果承认了。然后呢，现在这个宿舍的情况有一些改变。
So during that our investigation in 2006, we took a picture which showed that over 300 workers live in one dormitory room. It's a huge room. So Apple did acknowledge this fact, and it made some improvements in the living conditions.
然后我们有最近我们看到这个 Fair Labor 的这个调查，它也发现很多问题。其实这些问题在苹果2006年就已经发现了。
So FLS recent report did disclose some problem which were found out as early as 2006.
在过去的6年，实际上富士康实际上是没有什么实质性的改变。
In the past 6 years, Foxconn did not make any meaningful improvement.
比如说关于加薪这一点，就我并不认为有很大的变化。
For example, like wage increases, I don't think there was any real improvement.
从2004年到2010年、2006年期间，富士康工人的底薪经历了380元、400元、600元、700元、900元、1200元的变化。2010年工人跳楼事件以后，富士康把工人的工资调高到1550元。这个调薪实际上是中国物价指数上涨，富士康和其他工厂一样不得不调薪。
So from 2006 to from 2004 to 2010, base salary at Foxconn increased from 380 yuan to 400, 600, 700, 900, 1200. And after the spate of suicides in 2010, Foxconn workers' wage increased to 1550 per month. But this increase is mostly due to the inflation in China.
就富士康这个行业不一样，它是高强度。如果富士康不调薪，它招不到工人。像它调薪是为了要更好的招工人。招年轻的工人。
So if for industry like for factory like Foxconn, if they did not increase wages, it would unable to hire enough young workers which they need to work under such high work intensity.
那富士康的加班工资确实在减少，这个是确肯定的，就比以前。
It is true that overtime hours has been decreasing at Foxconn.
就相对2004年当时的调查，我们发现是工作320小时到350个小时之间，在2011年可基本上是减少到280个小时以下，工人时间减少，但是工作效益却提高了。也就是说，工人以前要做11个小时的工作，现在呢减少到10个小时就会完成，工人的劳动强度增加了。
So in 2004, we found out that workers' average hours in a month was 320 to 350 hours.But last year in 2011, the number has decreased to 280 hours per month. However, less overtime only means higher intensity at work. Workers now need to finish 11 hours of work within 10 hours.
就是说我们做过调查，就是说工人普遍感觉到非常累。还有另外一点，富士康的流失率非常高，也可以间接说明它的劳动强度非常大。
In our investigation, workers told us that they feel exhausted all the time. The problem of overtime is also indirectly proved by the high turnover rate at Foxconn factories.
就我认为这个评价这个富士康工资改那个就它的条件十分改善，我觉得有两个标准，一个是它那个加班时间减少，它一个是工资是不是一个生活的工资。
I think there are two indicators to evaluate whether the increase of salary and decrease of overtime is a real improvement.
第二个是劳动强度有没有减少。
First is whether the salary, whether the wages at Foxconn is a living wage. Second is whether the labor intensity.
就如果说他那个增，如果说他就减少工作时间的话，他增加劳动强度，等于就实际上没有什么对工人来讲，实际上压力增大了。
If they reduce the hours but increase the intensity for workers, their intensity is actually higher than before.
我们在那个当然不仅仅是富士康，我们在这个今年的一月份到四月份的时候，我们完成了十家苹果的这个供应商的调查。我们现在非常，我们现在在赶这个报告。我估计争取在这个月底会做一个，就是会公布这个报告。
Between January and April this year.We conducted investigations at 10 factories, 10 Apple suppliers in China. We are putting together a report and hopefully will be released very soon.
就苹果对他们的这个供应商是非常有影响力的。如果要改变这个工厂，首先苹果要改变。
Apple has a great influence over its suppliers. So if we want any change at supplier factories, Apple needs to change first.
现在这个苹果实际上他把他的责任是推给了这些他们的供应工厂，实际上问题是这样的，是苹果，如果苹果要改变，他只要付钱就可以了，他增加这个订单的价格，工厂就会变旺。如果说他就算再做审计，不去改变，不去增加他的价格的话，工厂情况永远不会改变。
Now Apple is only blaming its supplier for all the issues and the problems. The fact is, if Apple increase the order price and they pay higher,price, all the suppliers will have the ability to make improvements.
然后另外一个就关于最近苹果请的第三方审计，我想谈谈我的看法。
I would also like to share a few. I would also like to share a few thoughts on the audit report conducted by FLA.
就是说，第一个，我认为这个苹果和非政府组织合作，据我了解是第一次，那么也说明是公众压力的成功，让苹果被迫和第三方合作。
As far as I know, this is the first time that Apple ever working together with a nonprofit with an NGO. So this is also shows that the pressure from outside is a success.
然后第二点我要强调的是 ，field labor 已经有十年的历史了，很多公司加入 field labor， 但是呢 ，field labor 在中国做的工厂的调查，据我了解，所有的工厂没有一家比富士康的情况好。目前为止，他们在中国的工厂，他们加入他们这个公司 field labor 审计过工厂，没有一家工厂条件好过富士康的。
So secondly, I would like to point out that FLA has been in existence for 12 years, and they have conducted thousands.Dozens of investigations in China, but not a single one factory that supply factories conditions is better than Foxconn.
我为了要这个说明这一点，我最近我刚刚去调查了以前我们调查的加入 field labor 的一些工厂，就是在 field labor 委员那个就是他成员会的跨公司下面的工厂。那么我们发现现在这工厂每周工作80个小时。然后呢，工资还比富士康的工资低。
In order to prove this, I did a recent follow-up investigation on other supplier factories and found out that the conditions at other supplier factories are even worse, and the overtime is actually at 80 hours per month.
那么这个富士康和那个苹果承诺要减少到每周那个49个小时，那么这个就是说。实际上这个标准的话，实际上在目前来讲，我没有感觉到在中国有一家工厂实现了这个标准。我是说，就是台湾和香港的这公司下面的这工厂，我泛指，因为有可能有一些有直接投资的这工厂有可能达到了，就比如说美国直接投资了，或者中国的国营企业。但是呢，台湾、香港和韩国的工厂，据过去我十几年的调查，没有发现一家 是在49个小时控制加班时间的。
Apple and Foxconn promised to reduce overtime to 49 hours, but based on my experience over the last decade, I can say that not one single factory, like especially Hong Kong, Taiwan, and Korean-owned factories, can meet that standard. All the overtime hours are over 49. Or none of the FLA member corporations have met that.
然后第三个，我觉得这个 field labor 他们出的这个报告，很大程度是为苹果做公关，而且成为苹果的一个挡箭牌。
So thirdly, the FLA audit is mostly just a public relations act for Apple.
那么这个它的公关策略非常有水平，就是说他们一方面强调了富士康的问题，但是把关键的劳动强度、学生工安全问题淡化了。
So this is a very smart move. So Apple actually just blame all its suppliers for all the problems and underestimate all the problems, other problems like student interns, health and safety issues.
当然我觉得这个跨国公司应该和非政府组织合作，我觉得这个可能能够总体来改善。但是呢，在跟跨国公司合作的时候，不要去为他公关，而是真正的你想要去改善这个劳动的条件，这个是最关键的。如果你要跟跨国公司合作，那可以，但问题是你要更多的去考虑去做一些劳动条件的一个改善，比如有一些，就是说你可以踏踏实实做一些事情，而不是大规模的去做这个宣传，而且在电视里面说富士康不是血汗工厂。
I think it's okay for NGOs to cooperate with multinational corporations, but the issue is you cannot do PR for the corporation. So especially when they just say announce public that like Foxconn is not a sweatshop and they don't, you know, so all these are just a PR for the corporate.
就像我们这种非政府组织，比如 SACCON 还有别的组织，做了很多人努力工作，然后让这个苹果终于面对这个问题要做改善了。然后一个非政府组织说啊，它不是全工厂，它已经很好了，那我们所有的努力都没了。
So many other organizations like China Labor World, SACCON, and many other organizations have been working on this issue for many years. But then, if you have another NGO saying that this is not a sweatshop, conditions are good, so our efforts are just wasted.
对，然后另外一点就苹果是世界最有钱的公司，实际上苹果有条件来改善，它不像别的公司，别的公司可能没钱，但是苹果有钱，如果苹果有改变的话，就会带来其他公司的改变。
So another thing is Apple has the money to do so. So they have the capacity to make any changes. If Apple makes the changes, it will lead other companies in the industry to improve as well.
那就是说，如果苹果它改善了，就可能别的公司会跟进，因为苹果开始做了这些事情以后，它会带来一个好的效果。如果我觉得苹果表达承诺49个小时，这些我觉得是一个积极的地方，但是问题是要去实现它。
So if Apple makes the changes, companies in the industry will follow the lead. For example, if Apple promised no more than 49 hours of overtime. So the problem is like, if it's realized, how will it be realized?
那么当然就是说从长期来讲的话，改善雇佣的条件的话，当然需要跨国公司、非政府组织，包括中国政府和美国政府的多方的这种合作来改善的。
So in the long run, so in order to improve conditions at factories, it need efforts from multiple players like NGOs, the brands, and the Chinese and U.S. Government.
但是要有一个开头，比如苹果，我希望它能够带一个好的开头，这个是很重要的。我觉得它在这种压力下面，有可能会开始做一些事情。
But there has to be a start, and Apple should take the lead. If they start to do something good, I think this is a good start.
所以说，我们要保持对苹果的压力，促成它的变化。
So we need to keep the pressure on Apple and force it to change.
我土地长到这里，谢谢大家。